We are rising steadily. We have a nice uptrend in the last 2 or 3 weeks. Momentum is obviously a little bit overbought.
Welcome back, Bruno. Good to have you here.
Yes. Hello. How are you?
Very good. Now, Japan has been in the headlines. It's the big story we're starting off with because of the Nikkei, because it's at its higher high. But how far can it actually go?
Well, let's look at the weekly charts here. We have 3 years of data. What we see is that in 2015, we were resistance at 21,000. And now we're at 20,800 or a bit plus. So it's very likely that we're going to meet that target, 21,000. If it rises above it, then the next one is 22,800. And probably we see that the momentum is still rising on the weekly basis, and it's just crossing up on the MACD, so it's a long-term move which could develop.
Now for the Nikkei, what kind of support needs to be broken for us to get a warning?
Well, maybe we need to look at the daily chart for that. Here we see that we are rising steadily. We have a nice uptrend in the last 2 or 3 weeks. Momentum is obviously a little bit overbought on both indicators. And therefore, what we can do is take the previous high, which is 20,400, or eventually the support of the 2 days before, which is going to be 20,600 as of today. So that's the level to watch. If it breaks below that, then there is some troubles, but else it looks good.
So also in Asia, emerging markets are doing very well. Is this helping to support the bullish case?
Yes, it should, but let's differentiate a little bit. If we look at, for example, India, what we notice is that since we met 2 weeks ago, we have a very nice rebound, which is not yet exactly reaching the top of the range, but it's not far from it. As we see, the relative strength of India versus the S&P 500 has been rising, but over emerging market, it's kind of flat. So that means it's not the leader anymore. So we should look at China as probably the leader currently. We notice that we still have a very nice uptrend with the two channels here, lines. And after hitting the top of the channels, we are just pausing a little bit. And the relative strength is also pausing. And finally, so that's going to be relatively neutral short term, but as the trend is up, it should extend. And we see also even Brazil has been less bullish, but still in a neutral trending range with a nice rebound in the last 2 weeks.
Now looking to Europe, that rose in the last 2 weeks as well. Is that also going to be bullish?
Well, let's look at a little bit longer term here. We have 6 or 7 months. We noticed that obviously since beginning of September, on here on the charts, it has been moving up. And then we notice also this big, long blue trend line, resistance trend line, which is just passing at 36.25. We are just below it, 36.00 now. So the question is really, can we break that through? When we break that through, we will get a better, stronger signal. Meanwhile, it's just a little bit pausing sideways, but the trend is still up.
Now, with all the markets doing so well, does the US have that opportunity to take that top spot?
Maybe that's the question that many people are asking themselves. They see uptrends everywhere. If we look at the S&P on a weekly basis, what we noticed is two things. Number one, last week we reached 2550. 2550 was a target, for an extension target from this consolidation we had between 2400 and 2450. And now also we notice that the momentum is extremely high, overbought, that the VIX in here in orange is still below 10%. So it means a lot of complacency is in the market. Nobody fear anything about any pullback or any correction. And we were wondering if the pause that we had 2 weeks ago in emerging markets on the relative strength versus the S&P that was coming down a little bit was not announcing something. So here we really need to realize that above 2550, we've got another target, which is 2590, and see if it extends right away.
So why do you select the 2540 as a key support line?
If we want to have cutoff levels to change views, Now that we have so overbought, we need to select something which is not too far from the current price. It looks close, but in fact, we noticed that in the last 4 or 5 days, we're making a mini range between 25.55 and 25.40. So if it can extend, it's fine. Usually rectangles or horizontal levels open up the way to higher levels. Just if it fails, it's a signal. So if it breaks below the support, that would be a little signal, and therefore it would coincide with the toppy momentum here.
So finally, are there any other warnings we should be looking out at?
We could look at other different markets. For example, we could look at the Nasdaq. The basic sector which has been leading the whole markets up is technology. Recently, as we see here on this chart, we move above 6,012, which has been 6,000, has been a resistance for a long time, since July. So the fact that we move above it, it gives a bullish signal, unless it breaks back below it. So what we want now, as we are not far at 60, 50, something like that, what we want to see is a break below 60, 20. That would be a signal. Another possibility is to look at what's happening on assets which are usually bought when fear is increasing. Let's look at gold, for example. Here we have a very nice downtrend in the last 4 weeks in September, while the market was rising here on the orange line. And what we noticed yesterday is a break above the downtrend line. So maybe it's an initiation of people who realize that the price of gold is too low compared to the price of the S&P, which is too close to a top, possibly. So that could be another hint. And finally, what we should notice and look at is the US 10-year yield. While we were reaching the top at 25.50, the rates were also rising all the way up to 2.40%, 2.4%. And that's from here a pause has started. If a pause starts, that could also coincide with a little pause on the S&P. So that's all the different kind of things that we can look at in the coming days.
Well, thank you so much, Bruno, for joining us in the studio. It's been
a
pleasure.
You're welcome.
And thank you at home for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to Dukascopy TV so you never miss an episode with Bruno. Goodbye for now.